Listening session portion of our St. Louis County Board meeting. And I do have everyone, all of commissioners that are going to be here today are here. Commissioner Harlow is out ill today. But I do have one person signed up, Rick.
That's me.
Johnston?
Yep.
Rick, please come forward if you would.
You don't have anything planned. You're going to wait for the meeting to start.
No, no. This is our listening session. Our meeting starts at 10 o'clock, Rick.
Okay. I'm here for an education. Actually, I'm here for my First Amendment right, but
all right.
I'll be more specific.
We appreciate you coming. Okay. Just go ahead and...
As I spoke to the two commissioners here before the meeting, I don't like dealing in rumors. I'd like facts on if we have any illegals, migrants, undocumented or newcomers in St. Louis County, and if so, are we paying for that with taxpayer money in any way, shape, or form? That's it.
You know, you're asking a question that I can't answer you at this point, but we can certainly ask that question of our Health and Human Services folks, and we can get you an answer back. Okay, I don't believe so, but again, I'm not gonna make a statement on it because I'm not certain. Okay.
Yeah, I see the stuff on TV.
If you would
northern southern border, all the trouble in that.
If
and
you
I'd
would
rather just come down here and ask.
Please provide. Brian, can our Deputy Administrator Fritzinger there? Please provide him with your phone number and your email address, and we will get that question answered for you to the best of our ability.
I appreciate it.
All right. Thank you for coming.
Then I can tell people rather than...
All right. Very good. Again, thank you. Thank you for coming. Is there anyone else that cares to address the board during this listening session portion of the board meeting? And I have a head shaking yes out there, so please come forward and address the board. State your name, if you would, for the record.
Alexa Barrick.
Very good.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Hopefully everybody is well. We were actually interested in coming up today. I am a 911 dispatcher, and I'm one of your 911 dispatchers. I'm both a citizen of the county, as well as working for our center here that works with the county. I can't say specifically that each of you has necessarily called 911, but I can assure you that someone in your family has. Your parents, your children, your teachers, the ones that you remember from back in the day, everyone has an emergency at some point in their life, and all they wish is for someone to be able to walk them through that. That is what I do. Every day, day in, day out, I bear the burden of that repeatedly to try and make sure that my fellow people in the county are safe. That is what I do. I bear the burden, and that is good with me. That's actually a calling for me. When I got into this field, I didn't know what it meant to be passionate about what you do, and then I learned. I've been able to move here. I've been able to be successful. I work with an excellent crew of people that are equally dedicated. We are proud. We are tired regularly, but that is life, and that's being an adult. And we finally feel seen in this county, and that is amazing. This is my third agency, the second within Minnesota. I've been a dispatcher for roughly 10 years. I can't tell you what that means to us. It's big. If you guys don't know what we're currently working on, we actually went to the Capitol yesterday. We are the second group to go. One of our people decided this is the year. We're going to make this happen. We're going to push for this. And we went to talk to a number of different legislators and senators regarding this bill to try and get us retired at 55. Honestly, 55 would be a miracle. I joke around because of my age, but there's a good chance I may not be able to retire until I'm, I don't know, 80, depending on what this Social Security system looks like at that point in time. But honestly, the wear and tear that happens, my ability to do this job that I love so much, will deteriorate at some point. And the option to be able to say, I've done my work, I've done what I can, and I need to rest now, is phenomenal. So thank you. That's just a part of who we are. I've got another party sitting up behind that would like to step up for a second. And then I've actually got some pins for you guys. These are actually dispatcher pins. They've got the gold stripe on the flag. If it's okay, if I can approach and actually give them to you. Please.
All right, thank you for coming. Please come forward if you would. State your name.
Hi, my name is Andrea Hubadunk. I'm also a dispatcher for St. Louis County. I've been working for St. Louis County for about 2 years now, and it's honestly been an honor and a privilege to get to work for our community and get to take calls day in and day out of people who might be in the worst moment of the worst day that they've ever had, and get to be able to be the ones to be talking to them and reassuring them that help's on the way. And in a county as large as ours, sometimes be able to provide the assistance long before physical help can get on scene, because in some of the rural areas here, it will be a while before the ambulance gets there. And so in the meantime, we're the ones who get to provide that service. So as Alexa said, yesterday we were at the state capitol with some others talking to senators and representatives about this bill that we're trying to bring forward. And we do have another group down there today, and it truly does mean the world of difference when we can go into those meetings and say, we have the support of our own county and we have the support of our own sheriff. We also understand that this has been a very quick ask, and we really appreciate how quickly you guys have been able to come forward and support us. Because for a role where we're often the invisible part of public safety, you guys have really made us feel seen, and that's very appreciated. So we just really want to express our thank you for supporting us in general with this, but also how quickly you did. And as far as I've understood, some of you have even come into dispatch, whether to just take a tour or learn about us, or even sit with us for a couple hours to learn really what kind of calls we take. And it's all been noticed, and we all recognize that, and we just really want to express how thankful we are.
Very good. Thank you for coming forward. I have to tell you, there is a letter circulating. I don't know. I know that Commissioner Boyle has been circulating it. So whatever commissioners are signing off. The truth is, I would like to not have signed the letter, because I don't want our dedicated staff up there to retire, okay? But I understand the stress of that situation. And I've actually sat up at the 911 center on a midnight shift many years ago now, but it hasn't changed much. It's still just as stressful. It's still just as many issues going on. You can sit there all day long, but when you're there at midnight or 1 o'clock, that's a whole different, it's a whole different game up there. And I understand that. So I wish you success down there. Obviously, you're at the right place asking for it, but we'll have to see where that one goes. In this session, you can pretty much flip a coin as to what might happen and what might not. So good luck with it, and don't give up on it. If you don't get it this year, don't give up on it. It'll just be a, you know, it might take one or two times down there to get it done, but I think you've got a good argument given the stress of the job. So we'll see where that one goes. I'm not going to allow you to speak again. I'm sorry. I apologize. I just don't want to set the precedent. Okay. But I think you've got a lot of support on this board. Okay. And the only reason I'm not setting the precedent, we can come out and talk to you afterwards, but we only let people come up and talk to us once during this portion of it. And if I start letting people come back up a second time, it will run away from me in a hurry. Okay. So thank you again for coming. Thank you for the work you do for the people of St. Louis County. I can speaking on behalf of this board and on behalf of the people of this county, I think everybody understands the stress and what y'all do for us. 200,000 calls a year. That's a bunch of calls. Okay. So, all right. With that, there's nobody else here. So we'll stop with that. And again, if commissioners want to come out and visit with you, they can. And you can stick around, okay? But we'll wait if anybody else is coming. We'll start the board meeting at 10 o'clock, folks.